Good morning, everybody. How's everyone doing this morning? Amen. God is good. Amen. Yes, amen. Welcome to those that are watching live. And today is the day that the Lord has made. Amen. Let us be glad and let us rejoice. Amen. We need to give him glory. We need to give him everything. Amen. We need to give him our everything we have. These altars are open. Feel free to come up and just sit and just worship the Lord however you want to worship him. Amen. You know, there's times when the Lord wants us to be quiet, and there's times when we need to rejoice, and we should always rejoice. Amen. But there's times when, you know, the Lord wants us to be quiet, but I encourage you to come up to the front. We have all this space. Amen. And God is good. Amen. Let's pray. Father God, we just thank you, Lord. We give you honor today, Father God. We worship you, Father God. We magnify your holy name this morning. And we thank you, Lord, for this this time, Father God, that we have with you, Father God. Lord, just open our eyes and our ears and our hearts, Father God, to receive what you have for us this morning. We give you all honor this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, Rihanna is not here, and we're going to put some music on. So, like I said, you can come up here. I encourage you to come up a little closer and just let God have his way with you. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
How great! is my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. 'Cause I am found, I am yours, I am loved, I'm made pure, I have life, I can breathe, I am healed, I am free. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. 'Cause I am found, I am yours, I am loved, I'm made pure, I have life, I can breathe, I am healed.
God is good. Amen. He's good all the time. He is good. Thank you, Father. You're a good God. Taste and see what the Lord has done. How many of you have tasted and seen what the Lord has done? Amen. Amen. I'm sure everybody has some type of testimony. Amen. Amen. Blessings. All right. I'm going to read from you Deuteronomy 28. Blessings for obedience. I'm going to read it in the NIV. All right. If you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all nations on earth. Amen. All these blessings will come upon you and accompany you if you obey the Lord your God. Amen. Amen. You have been blessed in the city and blessed in the country. The fruits of your womb will be blessed, and the crops of your land and your young of your livestock, the calves and the herds and the lambs of your flocks. Your baskets and your kneading trough will be blessed. Amen. You will be blessed when you come and in and blessed when you go out. Amen. God is good. Amen. The Lord will grant the enemies who rise against you will be defeated before you. They will come at you from one direction but flee from the others in seven. Amen. The Lord will send a blessing in your hands, in your barns, and in everything you put your hands on. Wow, that's awesome. Amen. All right, amen. The Lord your God will bless you in the land he has given you. The Lord will establish you as his holy people, as he promised in you an oath. If you keep the commands of the Lord your God and walk in his ways, then all the peoples of earth will see that you are called by his name of the Lord, and they will fear you. Amen. The Lord will grant you abundance, prosperity in the fruits of your womb, the young of your livestock, and the crops of your ground. In the land he swore to your forefathers to give you, the Lord will open the heavens, the storehouse of his bounty. Amen. To send rain on the land in season and to bless all the work of your hands. You will lend to many nations, but will not borrow from none. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. If you pay attention to the commands of the Lord your God that I give you this day and carefully follow them, you will always be at the top and never at the bottom. Amen. Do not turn aside from any of the commands I give you today, to the right or to the left. Amen. Following other gods and serving them. Amen. God has been so good to us throughout the years. He's never let us down. Amen. He's always there for us. He is a good God. You can bring your tithes and offerings. And the reason why we give, I mean, it should be in our DNA. You know, we should have that same heart that Jesus has. Go ahead, y'all can bring him up. You should have that same heart, that giving heart that our Lord Jesus Christ has. You know, it being Thanksgiving, we should give to others that don't have. Amen. Help others. That's something that we should do every day. Amen. As Christians, God is good, and he's blessed us, and we've never been without. Amen. He is a good God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. You're so good, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for us, Father God. And we continue to praise you and worship you, Father. And Lord, we just bless those that have given here this morning, Father God. And continue, Lord, to bless them, Father. And for those that didn't, Father God, you know their situation, Father God. We just thank you, Lord, and we give you honor, Father, today, every day, Father. And we just We thank you for your love and your mercy and your grace, Father God, that you pour on us, Father. Thank you for salvation, Father. Thank you for the blood, Father. And thank you, Father, for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. You are good. Now for announcements. Yes. Okay. All right, announcements. Visit us on vclockhart.com. Wednesday night service is at 7, Bible study, A Better Way to Pray with Andrew Womack. Class for the youth at 7. Children's class at 7. Children's class at 7. Bring a friend and join us for fun weekly activities and snacks. Join us for a night of worship. Amen. Of worship, November 17th at 6 o'clock, starting with food and fellowship, following by worship, and ending with prayer. Amen. That is awesome. That is going to be an awesome time. Amen. We're going to have chalupas, okay? Amen. I'm going to be here. Sunday, December 1st, combined service at 10 o'clock, okay? This is December 1st at 10 o'clock, followed by a church holiday meal. We will have a menu posted soon when you can sign up for specific items. And English service is at 9 a.m., and Spanish service is at 11. Amen? And that's... We have a special Veterans Day up here that we're going to show you. We thank all the veterans. If you would stand up. Who's all veteran here? It's just Geneva. Okay. Geneva, thank you for your service. And we'll go to the video. Richard Mendez, too. We're missing Richard Mendez. He is a veteran. And yes. Amen. Thank you, veterans. And I'm going to ask Pastor Sally to come up to lead us on the word. Amen.
Before I get started, I have a little token of our appreciation to our veterans. If anybody else here is a veteran and I don't know about it, you need to let me know, okay? Because we want to honor you as well. Sister Geneva, will you come up here? It's a little token. Makes me want to cry. This is You know how sometimes when don't leave. Sometimes when you buy something or you go out to eat or, you know, there's always a survey. You know, could you give us 5 stars? Or, and, you know, you go on there and give them a survey. Give us 5 stars. So we have 5 little stars here. They're made out of ceramic. They're made by a special potter. They come all the way from Colorado. When we saw them, we thought of you. And it says, we're giving you our 5 stars. That means excellence. And we appreciate you so much for your service.
Thank you.
Your bravery. And you saw a lot of women on there. Women, they're brave, too.
Yes. Can I say something?
Of course.
Well, hold on. That's okay. I'm got a big mouth.
Yeah, but it won't record. It's not going to record it. Can you reach it? There it goes.
Hello? I just wanted to say that, okay, I have 2 granddaughters. One of them is in the Army, and the second one just joined the Air Force. And she's leaving on the 18th.
Oh,
Jody, the second one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and so keep them in prayer.
Amen.
Okay, that was all. I just appreciate your prayers for them.
Thank you, Lord. Following after Grandma's footsteps. It's an awesome blessing. Thank you.
We ready?
Thank
you.
I come with my own cheerleader. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray. We'll get started. Thank you, Lord. And what did y'all think of that song? That was an awesome song, the last one. Here's my heart. Here's my life. And speak what is true. Amen. Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning, Father, just so overwhelmed with your goodness, Father. Father, I pray, I thank you, Lord, for this word that you've given me, Father. I thank you, Lord. We come, Father, like Pastor said, with a heart expecting, Father, to receive a word from you, Father. We're here to be touched by you, Father, to be in communication with you, Father, to be together with our brothers and our sisters, Father, that we come together in unity, Father, to honor and glorify you, Father, and to thank you for all your goodness, Father. So we come, Lord, singing as we sang, Father, here's our heart, here's our life, Father. We surrender it to you, Father. So, Father, we surrender this morning. I pray, Father, that you would speak your truth, Father, through me, Father. I surrender less of me and more of you, Father. I thank you for the word. I pray that our heart would be ready, Father, that our ground would be tilled, Father, that we would receive a word. It would take root in our hearts, Father. Open our spiritual eyes, our spiritual hearing, Father, to hear and see and receive what the Spirit of God has for each one of us, Father. We give you all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus Christ, amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm excited. I thank the Lord for when I am weak, he is strong. I'm strong in him. Amen. Today I'm going to continue talking about being thankful. And the title of my message is Be Thankful in All Things. Amen. How many of y'all do that already? I'm thankful all the time. Are you thankful in all things? It doesn't matter what you're going through, where you've been, whatever you're struggling through. We need to be thankful in all things, in the middle of trials and tribulations, always. Amen. Ephesians 5:19-21. Paul was in prison when he wrote Ephesians. He was in prison when he wrote Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, and Philemon. Amen. And Ephesians was written to the church. And it says in verse 19-21, it says, speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in our heart to the Lord. That's what we did when we sang the blessing. We're singing the blessing, but we're singing it to one another. We're here and we're hearing it because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. And we're hearing that blessing that someone's singing over us. And you receive that. You're singing it out to everyone here and everyone's singing it back to you. Isn't that awesome? And verse 20, it said, giving thanks always for all things to God the Father. Always, not sometimes, always. Give thanks always to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. 21, submitting to one another in the fear of the Lord. That's not being afraid of the Lord, but that's reverential fear of the awesomeness of God. Amen? Thank you, Lord. Always giving thanks in everything. Thanksgiving was a way of Apostle Paul lived a life of thanksgiving. He was always thankful. Amen? It was a daily reality in his life. And he was a joyful person, even in the midst of persecution and being in jail. Amen? Thanksgiving or giving thanks, you know, we're always thinking, we think more about Thanksgiving in the month of Thanksgiving. We celebrate a day called Thanksgiving. But Thanksgiving is an action, and Thanksgiving is just giving thanks at all times to God and all his blessings. Amen? Because, you know, I mean, we have been blessed with every spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. Amen? Ephesians 1:3, we have all his blessings that we got through the Son of God. Amen? Thank you, Lord. We must not allow a spirit of ingratitude to harden our hearts and make cold our relationship with God and with others. Amen? A thankful heart keeps you in better communication with the Lord and just filled with that joy of the Lord. Amen? We have to thank God for our material blessings as well, man. All the blessings that he gives us. You know, we seem to never be satisfied with what we have. You know, there's always something, you know, or we don't have enough. We're poor or we're rich or we're sick or we're healthy. There's always something. But what makes a difference and is that when we realize that everything that we have comes from God. Amen? That's a great revelation, a great realization that everything that we have, God has given it to us. Amen? David understood this in 1 Chronicles 29, verse 12 to 14. This scripture, David was giving, he was an example of giving. Amen? He was giving for the temple to be built. His son Solomon was going to build it, and David had a grateful heart to the Lord. He was so thankful to the Lord that he started giving all out of his riches and everything, and that encouraged all the people that were there to give. And they gave so much that they had more than enough. Amen? And here in verse 12, it says, both riches and honor come from you. Amen? Our riches and our honor comes from God. And you reign over all. In your hand is power and might. In your hand it is to make great and to give strength to all. Now, therefore, our God, we thank you and praise your glorious name. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. We praise your glorious name. But who am I? Amen. Who am I and who are my people that you should be able to offer so willingly as this? For all the things come from you. Everything comes from you. Amen. And of your own we have given you. Amen. When you give to the Lord, we're giving back to what already belongs to him. Amen. It's his. David gave the Lord credit for all his prosperity. Amen. God is the source of all prosperity, whether we realize it or not. Amen. Everything comes from God. God gave us all our talents, everything that's in our hands. Amen. And we should thank the Lord that he found us he found us trustworthy to be stewards of what he has put in our hands. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Those who aren't thankful and don't praise God, don't focus on God as their source. Amen. When you realize that everything, it's not your job or your retirement check, or whatever you receive, or how you make your living, it comes from God. God may be using that job to provide for you, but ultimately, God is our source. Amen? David gave back to the Lord what was already his, and we should have the same attitude. Anything we give to the Lord, something is something that he's already given to us. Amen? Thank you, Lord. So we shouldn't be preoccupied about what we do or don't have, you know, but just trust in the Lord that everything you have comes from him. In Philippians 4 and verse 11 and 12, Paul declared this. He said, "Not that I speak in regard to need, for I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. I know how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things, I have learned both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer." Amen. Paul wasn't saying that he was grateful for the things that were given to him, but he was just blessed because the Lord was providing for him. Amen. They brought him gifts, and he said it wasn't the gift. It what blessed Paul was that they brought him a gift. Amen. That they brought him something, and you know that it. When somebody gives you something, you get something, you know, it's to show you how much they love you or appreciate you. So Paul was overwhelmed that people were giving in to him, and he was thankful. He had a spirit of thankfulness, you know, and that made all the difference in his life. If you know how much he suffered, you would think, you know, it's awesome that, you know, he was more focused on just thanking the Lord. So we got to thank God for the people in our life. Amen. There's so many people in our life. The Lord brings different people in our lives. You might not know it at the moment, you know, but maybe down the line you said, "Oh, I remember, you know, that person down there, and I know now what her job was, why I had to meet her or him," right? This morning I was thinking about La Hermana Tellez, Maria Tellez. She was a missionary to Mexico, and we worked with her for a lot of years, and she was such an encouragement to me. You know, and now I know why she was in my life. Amen. Because you even, God sends all kinds of people into our lives. Amen. Some are temporary for a little bit, and some are lifelong friendships. Amen. But they're always there to encourage you, or we should learn something from those relationships. Amen. Take from these people and be appreciative to the people that God has sent to be around you. Amen. It's so easy to take people for granted, amen, even to complain and become angry because they don't meet our needs or they don't do what we want them to do, you know. A lot of people want to get, I'm saying, you know, do you know? No, I'm supposed to be here to tell you. You know, a lot of people think, when I get married, then I'll be content. And the people that are married say, well, when I'm not married, maybe I would be content if I was single, but we're never content when, you know, we're never content. I'm going to stop saying that. We're always looking at what we don't have instead of what we do have. And we need to be thankful for those people that are around us, our friends, amen, our spouse, our brothers, our sisters, our children, you know, the relationships here at church. You know, you're my brothers and sisters. You're my family. And so we're grateful for you. How many marriages and relationships grow cold? And it's all based because of the sin of ingratitude. We forget to tell them how much we appreciate them and how much they mean to us. You know, God, help me stop saying, you know. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for the people in my life. I was thinking about all the ladies that come to all the ladies here, everyone here, and the ladies that come to the meetings and how we've built our relationship, and every one of you means so much to me, you know, and it encourages me and that helps me, and I think we're there for one another, and sometimes it's that just that hug, that million fire hug that I need on Sunday mornings. I tease Sister Carmen, and her last name is 100 Fires, 100 Fuegos. And I said, I need a hug of fire this morning. And she always gives me a good one. I appreciate her so much. Amen. So we appreciate and we're thankful for the people in our lives. The Christians in Corinth were far from perfect, and we know the story of Corinth. But in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 4, it says, Paul is thanking the people, even though they weren't all perfect. It was a chaotic place. But he says, I thank my God always concerning you for the grace of God which was given to you by Christ Jesus. And that's us, my husband and I. We're always giving thanks for all of you and praying for you because we love you. You're a family. And the Lord has put you under our care, and we take it seriously. So we're always praying and encouraging you and available anytime you call us. Amen. Paul was on his journey to Rome, and he was facing imprisonment. And on the way to Rome, he was shipwrecked. And it was a rough trip, but in Acts 28:15, there was a group of believers that came out to meet Paul, a man on the road. And in verse 28:15, it says, and from there, when the brethren heard about us, they came to meet us as far as Appii Forum and three inns. When Paul saw them, he thanked God and took courage. Amen. Appii Forum was about 40 miles away, and three inns was like 30 miles away. But when they heard that he was coming through their town, they traveled all that time just to come and encourage him. He was just encouraged by seeing them come to be with him. Amen. He was encouraged. And I have a little box that Sister Joanne made. It was a little box of encouragement. And all the ladies wrote a scripture or a note to me. So when I'm feeling discouraged, I can go to that little box and pull one out and be encouraged and remember how they blessed me. Amen. And that's a word that gives me courage. And we're supposed to, like it says, singing songs and hymns and encouraging one another. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So when Paul saw that these believers had come to honor him, he thanked God and he took courage. And it's important to honor God, amen, and those who serve the Lord. In 1 Samuel 2:30, it says, therefore the Lord God of Israel says, I said indeed that your house and your house of your father would walk before me forever. But now the Lord says, far be it from me, for those who honor me, I will honor, and those who despise me shall be lightly esteemed. Amen. Paul was encouraged, amen, by these people. He was encouraged. Yes, I'm being encouraged. I get encouraged by the women that are around me and my brothers that, you know, support me and back me up, and my cousins, all my family. Amen. It's an encouragement to me. Thank you, Lord. So we have to be thankful for these people, thankful for everyone that's around you, thankful for the people that the Lord has sent into your life. Amen. And he will be sending this next year. There are going to be people around you that you're going to have to reach out to. And I'll tell you a little bit about that in a little bit. But this morning I just felt this impression that in this coming year, it's going to be important that we share the Jesus with other people to win souls. That's going to be our focus point for this next year. Amen. To win souls for the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank God in the midst of trials and even persecutions. No one wants to go through a difficulty or through a trial or be persecuted. It's no fun. Amen. But we're supposed to thank God in the midst of them. We're not thanking God because of the trial, but we're thanking God because we know that he's with us. In John 16:33, it says, these things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. Thank you, Jesus, for air. I just felt that cold air. Thank you, John. Thank you, Lord. I'm grateful for AC. In the world, you would have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Jesus has overcome the world. Amen? You may be going through a trial or a tribulation, or, you know, somebody's persecuting you. And that's no fun. It's not say be happy about what you're going through, but be happy and peaceful and joyful that you're not alone. Jesus is right there with you. Thank you, Lord. And he's going to help you through. He's got an answer for your problem, yeah? In the midst of those trials, we can thank God because we know he has promised to be with us and help us through life. Amen. James 1:2, it says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Amen. It's producing patience. Patience is a fruit of the Spirit. Amen. It's building you up. It's making you stronger. You learn to be patient through that, but it makes you stronger. So the next time another trial comes up, you're a little bit stronger. Soon enough, then you're not going to, it's not going to be, it's going to seem like you're never going to have a trial again, but you might be going through a trial, but you can be peaceful and joyful in the middle of it. Amen? And not be done, you know, down or depressed because God is with you. Amen? Thank you, Lord. None of us are exempt from any kind of trouble. And yet, in the midst of those trials and tribulations, we can thank God because we know that he has promised to be with us and that he will never leave us. Hebrews 13:5 says he will not forsake you. Amen? That he would never leave you or forsake you. And we thank God for always being with us. And a lot of great men in the Bible have went through trials and tribulations. We all know the story of Daniel, right? He was in Daniel in the lion's den. When he learned in Daniel chapter 6, he learned that they were plotting to destroy him. They wanted to kill him because he would not serve the king's God. He was serving God, and nothing was going to change his mind from serving the Lord. And so they were trying to kill him because he was second in command, and they didn't want him around the people at that time. And so in Daniel 6, verse 10, it says, now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, it was an order to have him killed, he went home and his upper room with his windows open toward Jerusalem. He knelt down on his knees 3 times that day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as it was custom in those days, in those early days. Amen. They told him, don't pray to your God anymore. And you need to stop doing that. We're going to throw you in the lion's den. And what did he do? He opened the window so they could hear him. And he prayed, because they prayed 3 times a day in those days, and morning, noon, and evening. And he opened the window so they could hear him loud and clear. Nothing was going to stop him. Amen? Amen? We need to have that kind of, strength, that kind of persistent. You know, nothing's going to stop me from serving my God. Amen? Thank you, Lord. And what happened to him? They threw him in the lion's den. I think that's a trial, right? And there were a lot of lions in there that were hungry. And what did they do? Right? They didn't even touch him. They waited for the evil people. Watch out, evil people. They took Daniel out, and the king was happy. He didn't want Daniel to go there, but he signed the order without thinking about it. Go read the story. And so he was relieved that Daniel wasn't hurt, but then they threw all the evil people in there, and they got devoured. So we don't want to be on that side. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So the Bible tells us and commands us to give thanks. In 1 Thessalonians 5:18, it says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Amen? In Colossians 1:12, Paul declares, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. You are qualified. Amen? Amen? You are qualified to be partakers of the inheritance. Amen. God is our Father. Yes. Jesus is our brother. He's our God. He's our Lord. But he's also our brother, co-heir. We're co-heirs with him. Amen? And we have a father. Don't cry yourself poor. Our father is a bazillion, gazillion, whatever, billionaire. Amen? He's our father, and we're qualified to be part of his family. When we accept him as Lord Jesus, as Lord of our life and receive the salvation, we become part of that family. So we are rich. That's why it says we're not poor, we're rich. We're rich in Christ. Amen? Thanksgiving focuses our attention on God and not on unbelief and enemy schemes, right? I don't know what trial you're facing now today. You might be going through a trial, maybe not. But God does. He knows everything that's going on in your life, and he loves you, and he's with you. Amen? So you're never alone, ever alone. And then you got all these brothers and sisters here that are for you, that are cheering you on. Amen? And we love you, and God loves you, and he's never, ever, ever going to leave you. We got to thank God for his continued presence and power in our life. Amen? Amen. We've got to continue to thank God for that. When we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we're walking in a whole new life. Amen? We become new creations. He is with us. He wants to help you. He's for you. In Colossians 1:13, he says he has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of his son, of the Son of his love. In other words, when we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we're right here in this world, in this dark world, and living here day by day. But the minute we accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we walk into a new kingdom, and we're in a different kingdom. We might still live here. That's why it says don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. We need to be renewed to what the, you know, how to live in the kingdom of God. Amen. It's a whole new set of rules and laws and, you know, that we live by. I mean, we have to live by the law of the land, but, you know, we are more than conquerors in this world. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And he's given us all the power we need. Yes. Amen. To conquer and go through any situation that we may be going through. We have the power. You have the power. Hallelujah. You have the power. Let me give you some more convincing. Romans 8:11 says, but I don't think I gave you all these scriptures, Michael. It says, but if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, does that spirit dwell in you? Yes, it does. Because when you receive Jesus Christ, what happened? His spirit came to live in yours, right? Okay. So then it says, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies. Through his spirit who dwells in you. Amen. We got the strength. You got power in you. Hallelujah. 1 John 4:17, it says, love has been perfected among us in this. In what? That we may have boldness in the day of judgment. If you're being judged or when we go to judgment, we're going to have boldness through that time. Why? Because as he is, so are you in this world right now. You have the same power. You have God living power living in you. Hallelujah. Psalm 23:6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me and you, all of us, all the days of our life, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Power is working in you. It's working in you. In ourselves, we don't have the strength that we need to live, but the way God wants us to live. Amen? God's power in us. Philippians 2:13, it says, but it is God who works in you both to will and for his pleasure. Amen? God is always leading our born-again spirits. Amen? We have that spirit living in us. And we're influenced by the Holy Spirit, and he directs us into his will. Amen? He will direct us into his will, and that pleases God. That's what this is saying. It pleases God. But it's the Spirit of God that's leading us in our daily lives. Amen. God puts it in us, but we have to work it out. Amen. Every scripture says we need to work it out because it's in us. We need to allow it to work through us and in us. We need to read the word so we know what our rights are. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. He just showed me the Constitution. How many of y'all know what the Constitution says? Every amendment, everything that's in it, all of it. No, right? So if something comes against you, some law or something is being said, and you don't know if it's true or not because you haven't read the Constitution, then you're not going to be able to stand up in boldness and fight it, right? So it's the same thing. The Word of God, you need to know what it says so that you can use that power that's in you and fight back. Amen. Thank you, Lord. That's good. You did good. Thank you. You made me look good. Matthew 28, verse 18 to 20. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of age." Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We celebrate Thanksgiving every year, but for Christians, that day can be every day. Okay, I'm just reading. I wrote something that the Lord gave me this morning. And I believe that God has given us another chance, you know, to work for him. Amen. Through this election that we just went through, I think it was just the mercy of God, because we were facing, it wasn't going to be pretty, and it's still going to be a hard time. The work is still to be done. We need to keep praying for our president. We need to keep praying for our country. It's going to be a bumpy ride. You know, they've already tried to assassinate the president again. But I think the Lord has given us a second chance. The president was president number 45. We believe it was stolen in 46. And then in 47, he's back again, but he's a little bit different. And I think that the Lord's hand is in the situation all the way through. I'm not sure how really to explain it. I just feel this. And but it's God's hand was in it all. And I think this season, more Christians were waking up and finding that if we don't wake up, we're going to lose our right to worship together, to come together. We're going to be persecuted. And persecution might still come later on, but for a moment, we have a second chance to win more souls for the Lord. Amen? Maybe he's given us, because there's a third great awakening happening right now. We might not see it here in this town, or I'm not seeing it because I don't get out that much, but I hear about youth praying in high school, and I think Geneva's grandson had a Christian rally at the school, which is awesome that our young teenagers are on fire for the Lord. I'm at Mesa, at Brianna. She's 20 years old, and she's on fire for the Lord. She couldn't be here with us today, but, I mean, I see the excitement in her, and she's just like a magnet. You know, people just come to her and talk to her, and she's encouraging people, and other people are encouraging her. It's just amazing to see. We have a second chance, and we better stay awake and be awake, and don't lose your second chance. God has given us this second chance. Amen? And when we say that, you know, it doesn't matter if we vote or not. Yes, it does. It does matter. because it could just be one vote that's keeping. I know all, there's electoral votes and all that kind of stuff, but if they see the numbers, they have to go by the numbers. And I think a lot of Christians really woke up and went out to vote. And amen. That all the politics, even in our city government, it affects our lives. We think it doesn't, but it does. It affects our lives, the lives of our children, and we need to be awake and don't lose the opportunity. Amen? And that's going to be our focus for next year, to win souls for Christ. Amen? Ephesians 5:20. Giving thanks always for all things to God the Father in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Do you know the joy of having a personal relationship with the Lord? Thank you, Lord. Yes, it's joyful. You can have that joy. Joy is part of the fruit of the Spirit. Amen. It's in you. We have to thank God especially for his salvation in Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Lord. God has given us the greatest gift of all, and that was his Son, who died on the cross. He rose again so that we can know him personally and spend the rest of eternity with him. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Corinthians 9:15 says, thanks be to God for all his indescribable gifts. Hallelujah. For all his indescribable gifts. He gives us so much every day. Amen. The Bible tells us that we have been separated. We were separated from God because of sin, but God loved us so much, and he wants us to be part of his family forever. Amen? And he wants us to bring other people into his family. He doesn't want anybody to be lost. Amen? He's coming soon. We're seeing a lot of signs in these days. He's coming soon. And so now he's given us another opportunity to get those brothers and sisters that don't know the Lord to work on them. And where does it start? You said, I can't go out and be an evangelist or anything. It starts with your family, your sons, your daughters, everybody, your family, immediate, your mama, your daddy. Amen? Everybody. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. He loves us so much that he sent his only son to the world to die, a perfect sacrifice for our sins. And all we need to do is reach out in faith and accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Amen. John 3:16, we all know this one. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Have you ever opened your heart to Jesus? And probably almost everybody in here has opened their heart to Jesus and has received the Lord Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. But when was the last time you thanked him for your salvation? In the morning. Well, we got a morning person here that thanks him every morning for salvation. That's great. You know, sometimes we forget, you know, we're living a good life. Amen? Because it's the life that God has given us. And just to be alive. And to be alive in this time, it's an interesting time. You know, ever since the Spirit of God came down when he told his disciples to wait in Jerusalem until the Holy Spirit came upon them in Acts 1:8, right? Ever since that time, they've been preaching that the end is near. Amen. If they preached it back that long ago, how much closer are we now? Amen? And we see the signs and the prophecies. Some prophecies have already been fulfilled, and now there's more that to be fulfilled. But we're seeing those things. And it's not a time to be afraid, but it's a time to be excited. Amen? Because in Joel, it says that our young children are going to prophesy and our old people are going to dream dreams. The Spirit of God is going to be working through us so powerfully. It's going to be amazing. We're going to see signs and wonders that we've never seen before. Amen? That not like the ones we see here. We see people healed. We see cancer's gone. We see, you know, eyes to see. We've seen, my husband and I have seen people raised from the dead, or one person raised from the dead when we pray for them. But we're going to see all these things. It's an exciting time. It's not going to be easy. It's going to be a difficult time. But we're not alone. Jesus is in us. God is with us. Amen. His mercy is with us. His grace. Amen. So it is an exciting time right now. Ephesians 1:7 says, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. Amen. If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ in your heart, will you accept him today? People watching us online, will you accept him today? Amen. In Romans 10:9-10, it says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You will be saved.
Yes.
For with the heart one believes into righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Amen. It's that simple. The righteousness of faith just receives what Christ has already done. It's that simple. We just have to confess it with our mouth and say, Lord, come into my life. Amen. If you're watching us online and you want to pray a simple prayer with me, you can pray. And we believe that when you pray, believe in your heart, that you will be saved. Amen. So you could pray with me. And it says, Heavenly Father, I thank you, Father, as I'm reminded that this is the month of Thanksgiving, Father. I pray, Lord, that I would be mindful, that we would be mindful to give thanks to you in all things and every day, Father. To thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us. So, Heavenly Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I believe, Father, with my heart, I believe that you came to this world. You were crucified. You were buried. And the third day you rose up so that I could have salvation. You did it for me. And as I confess you, Father, that I make you the Lord and my Savior, I believe that I am saved. So, Lord, I thank you, Lord. I confess with my mouth that I make you the Lord of my life this day. Come into my life, Father, and do something with my life. I want to be part of the third great awakening, Father, that's happening now. I want to be involved. I want to serve you, Lord. And I thank you, Father, for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. It's that simple. And it's even more simpler. You know, just, I believe, I receive, and I thank you. Amen. It's that simple. Thank you, Lord. I'm just searching because as the Lord speaks to me in the morning, I wrote notes, but I think the main one for us is that our focus for 2025 is going to be to win souls for the Lord. That's going to be our job, and that's going to be our focus. And, you know, we were commenting, I don't know who I was commenting with. I'm still a little jet lagged. I'm not sure if I'm here or there, but thank you, Lord. Y'all pray for me? This morning, I just wanted to stay in bed. I said, the Lord, help me. Yes, thank you. I had to get up and repent. I said, Lord, forgive me for trying to be lazy. It's easy to be lazy, right? I said, no, sir, I'm up. And then I've got a pastor there to go, come on, you got a job to do. He bringing my coffee. Thank you, Lord. But what was my point? Focus to win souls in 2025. I forget what else I was supposed to tell you. Maybe nothing else. But anyway, if y'all want to stand, we'll pray. I believe a pastor has a word for us.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And I know the Lord is ready to help you. Yes. The only thing you have to do with this is be humble and say, Lord, I can't anymore. We can tie, I can tie it. This morning. I don't want it. My body, my mind, want, but my body say, hey. And I say, no,